announced lung cancer. Alexander Zavialov from Moscow. Hello, esteemed Presidium and colleagues. This presentation, the clinical part of work was carried out in Tomsk Research Medical Center, but there's the second institution from Moscow, a scientific practical center of oncology. Why we decided to carry out our own trial using local hypothermia? First and foremost, the figures you know well. These are statistics data for Russia. We see that the third stage of the process appears in 38-something% of cases, second stage 15.4%. And that's the category of patients to whom we have to carry out combined therapy. Different opinions are present, whether combined therapy may be used starting from 2B stage, but nevertheless, we hear more and more whether combined therapy may be used in third stage. Rationally combining surgery with chemo radiotherapy or stick to chemo radiotherapy per se. Next, stimulus was that the results of surgery depend on the stage of the process, plus what was said before, the stage I've shown to you. The first stage has the best results, second, third go down, and to be frank, we stick to the statement that chemo radiotherapy pre-op is more efficient compared to adjuvant therapy. There are many theoretical prerequisites, many publications, and in our trial, when we selected the material, we focused on this. A lot has been said about reasons for that. There are many biological reactions, including radio modification, meaning that the damaging action on the tumor of the radiotherapy on the tumor itself has to be increased, but the normal tissue has to be better protected. And many physical and chemical agents, including chemotherapy, tick agents are used. We focused on the use of local hypothermia that, as of today, is one of the most potent modifier of biologic reactions. The mechanisms of hypothermia are well studied and well known as of now. Cellular ones and tissue ones. Cellular ones, the decrease or blocking of replication and reparation of DNA, inhibition of neoangiogenesis mechanisms, and the reinforcement of the apoptosis of programmed cell death. The changes of tissue physiology, the reinforcement of vascular permeability and microcirculation that leads to high oxygenation of the tissue, inhibition of tissue breathing, and stimulation of the immune system, indirect one, thanks to the increase of activity of natural killers. As for the clinical use of hypothermia together with radiotherapy, a lot of information is used, including for the patients with non-operable, non-resectable tumors. In this sense, you see significant changes when such trials have been performed in terms of lung cancer. The goal of our study was the assessment of tolerability and the efficacy of the combined therapy for the patients with the third stage. A very diverse cohort of patients, and I must admit that within the framework of one oncology center, it's very difficult to form maximally representative groups that would correspond to the best of our knowledge to each other in terms of various parameters. Hence, this occupied a lot of time and efforts. A very interesting design of the trial. We have formed three groups of combined therapy. First one, thermo-chemo-radiotherapy, adjuvant chemotherapy, and pre-op radiotherapy. We tried to maximally synchronize these groups in terms of chemotherapy courses and radiotherapy prior to the operation. You see the point or the period when local hypothermia was performed in this scheme. Our dosage planning was performed after comprehensive examination of the patients with the help of spiral CT. As for local hypothermia, we used Celsius machine. The working frequency was 13.56 megahertz and maximal power of up to 600 watts. The process of hypothermia up to 10 sessions of hypothermic hypothermia tolerability. When we compared corresponding groups, we found out that adverse events were quite predictable and may be expected. The main focus is on well-known points: hepatotoxicity. For example, nephrotoxicity. As for local hypothermia with patients with their pronounced fatty tissue, sometimes were very the pain was well pronounced, and this effect very well described, and in publication we hear this about these situations. Here you may see the radio responses and complications. When we carried out this radiotherapy, they were quite standard. Weakness, esophagitis in one case, and pulmonitis and arrhythmia also. The efficacy of pre-op treatment, pre-op therapy. In chemo radiotherapy, the overall efficacy amounted to 70%, and stabilization of the process was quite high. As for complete regression, 10% had complete regression of the tumor that was confirmed by morphology after surgery. In now adjuvant radiotherapy, the main idea was the stabilization of the process. That's one of our clinical cases. With the help of CT and other methods of examination, we confirmed the squamous cell cancer. Chemo radiotherapy was prescribed, and after this therapy, prior to surgery, CT was performed, and it showed a very good regression of cancer. In terms of the volume of surgeries, the groups were comparable by lobectomies and combined operations. As for the nature of post-op complications, unfortunately, we must admit that we couldn't avoid them 100%. The maximum number of post-op complications was seen in a post-op group in thermo radiotherapy group. There were not so many of them. When we formed these groups, We certainly prepare the patients pre-op, and used all the resources we had for this. As for post-op mortality, in the group under study, there was no post-op mortality. Well, in other groups, we've seen it. And the main reasons for this post-op mortality were quite standard ones. Nothing to be added. Quite interesting is the pronouncement of pathomorphosis, therapeutic pathomorphosis. Fourth grade was seen only in the thermochemotherapy group. This allowed us to say that thermochemo radiotherapy impacts cancer quite beneficially. We thus correlated the degree of pronouncement of pathomorphosis and the efficacy, and in the thermoradiochemotherapy, this connection was better pronounced, and the efficacy was the highest. 2 years results are shown on this slide. In the group of thermochemoradiotherapy, 2 year survival was 85%, and much lower in the comparison groups. In case of metastasis in the regional lymph nodes, 0, 1, and 2, overall 2 year survival was higher in the group with the addition of thermal therapy. In conclusion, combined therapy of non-small cell lung cancer third stage, including pre-op chemo radiotherapy on the background of local hypothermia and radical surgery, is very well tolerated by the patients and does lead to the increase of the number of post-op complications. The use of pre-op thermochemoradiotherapy increases the frequency of objective response of the tumor, and it allowed us to improve the 2 years overall survival. Thank you. One question is allowed. Question is out of the mic. I understand. But tell me, please, in which countries it is more prevalent and in which clinics. It is maximally prevalent in case of non-operable, non-resectable tumors. Its transformation to be used among operable patients is quite rare, and it is quite widely used in the US, Hungary, and